Hello friends, welcome to the CAD/CAM CAE lecture series. In today's lecture we are going to see CNC lathe operation and in that rough turning and facing operation as well as grooving, that is single and multi-pass grooving. So first we will see a CAM cycle for rough facing and turning and then finish facing and turning. So in order to carry out a rough cut, okay, there is a specific CAM cycle. So on lathe machine, when I have to trace the cylindrical or machine the cylindrical workpiece, okay, very often I have to take the tool path keeps on the tool path that we select, okay, is a linear tool path and it keeps changing its orientation. So while it is going from, say, in a z direction, okay, while it is moving parallel to z direction, it is turning operation, but it can go up the climb, okay, it can go at a ramp height, it can straight go up, okay. So there is a possibility that some sort of facing also comes in that, and that these two things are clubbed together in a CAD cycle, and the code which is given is G73. So G73 is a CAD cycle code for rough facing and turning, okay, rough cut facing and turning. The block syntax goes like this. So you have sequence number, then G73, then P and Q are the reserved keywords. They will be indicating the specific line numbers, okay, between which the operation needs to be repeated, okay, operation needs to be repeated, or till these line numbers, okay, between these line numbers, okay, the program will continue executing the code, okay, of written on these block of lines specified by these parameters, okay. So P200 is a beginning code, G code for the sequence, the beginning sequence, okay, for the turning and facing cycle. And Q300 is a sequence number indicating at the end of machining, so that is turning ends. Okay, U.3, W.15. So U.3 indicates 0.3 millimeter of stock to be left on the x-axis. Okay, for turning, for turn finishing operation. Okay, so after it is can say mandatory, because we are looking at good surface finish. So if you are following a rough cut cycle, okay, it has to be followed by finish cut cycle. So if I am having a rough cut CAD cycle with the help of G73 code, okay, you will find that most of the cases, 99% of the cases, okay, there will be a finish turn and facing cycle, okay, with the help of G72, which we will see just after this. So 0.3 mm is a stock to be left on the x-axis, okay, for turn finishing operation, and as per diameter programming, stock left is 0.15 millimeter. So we are by default going to work in diameter programming. So stock that is left will be of 0.15 millimeter. Then W.15 is 0.15 millimeter stock left on the Z axis for face finishing operation. Okay. Then D3 is the depth of each rough pass. Okay. So that depth is to be 3 mm. And 0.2, that is feed 0.2, that is feed rate 0.2 millimeter per revolution. Okay. And it has to be followed by a finish cut cycle, that is finished CAM cycle for facing and turning. So the code is G72. Okay, block of syntax is very simple because already we have specified stock to be leave on x axis and z axis, and that extra stock which we have left during the rough cut cycle, that only we are going to machine, and there will be no stock left on the x and z axis. Okay, so we don't have to specify any limits, okay, for the G72, that is finish cut cycle. So this block syntax goes like, you have sequence number followed by G72 followed by the same sequence numbers, okay, set of sequence numbers. So P200, Q300, remember we gave P200, Q300 for the rough cut cycle as well, and the same set of codes we will be machining, or we will be executing to finish the workpiece, okay, to finish the workpiece and remove the this amount of material which we left during the rough cut cycle. So we will be only machining 0.3 mm stock in terms of x direction and 0.15 mm stock in terms of z direction. Okay, and that will be finished. So G72 is a G code for finish face and turn. P200 beginning of finish pass. Q300 sequence number indicating end of the finish pass. Okay, so this I think is not that difficult to understand. It is very very straightforward. Okay, how we will come to know which are the starting lines, starting sequence number and ending sequence number? What we can do? We can keep these values to be entered. Okay, we will write this and we'll keep these lines blank initially. Okay, we will trace the entire path and then mention the starting of the rough cut cycle and ending of the rough cut cycle. Most probably when we write this CAN cycle block, okay, it is assumed that the next sequence line, okay, the next sequence number should be the P number, okay, and end sequence number we can write later. Okay, so just to take an example, we will take this as an example for simultaneous rough facing and turning cycles. Okay, simultaneous rough cut facing turning cycles. So these are the end dimensions given. This is the tool path which needs to be followed. Okay, so these are the locations. Location number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, remember this will be held in the chuck jaw. So we will be machining till this point. Okay, now this 580 will be directly held in the chuck jaw. So we can assume that the workpiece, cylindrical workpiece which we got or which we will get will be of diameter 580. Okay, diameter 80. And we have to machine the end piece in this manner. So the distances are mentioned. The spindle speed is mentioned as 400 rpm and feed is mentioned as 0.5 millimeter per revolution. We will be selecting a rough cut tool for this. Okay, rough cut tool for this. And then in the finish cut, we will be selecting the finish cut tool. Okay, although we don't mention it in a manual program, okay, although we don't mention it in a manual program, okay, it is also possible that we can keep same tool. Okay, we can keep same tool, select a tool which is having a very less corner radius. Since it is a single point cutting tool, it has corner radius of the order less than 1 millimeter. So let's say 0.8 millimeter, 0.5 millimeter, 0.3 millimeter, okay, which is very very small. Okay, and if you are working with, let's say, 0.8 millimeter corner radius tool or 0.5 millimeter corner radius tool, then we don't actually have to change the tool during the finish cut cycle. Okay, we can work with same tool. Okay, what will happen in the finish cycle is, okay, since the stock removal requirement is very less, okay, the feed can be slightly modified and it can be slightly lowered, okay, to achieve a good amount of surface finish. So that is the only case. Okay, but in manual program we don't specify those many details. Okay, manual program is just to showcase how the rough cut facing turning and finish cut facing turning cycle has to be written in a code. Okay, and while we are working on a simulation environment, at that time we can work with, say, separate rough cut cycle with a different tool and separate finish cut cycle with a different tool. Okay, and at that time we can always modify the speed and feed values as and when we require. Okay, so this is the geometry. Okay, this is what the simulation environment result will show us. Okay, so yeah, I'll just run the simulation environment. So that is how the yeah, so first was the rough cut, as you can see till here. Okay, this was the rough cut cycle and after that the finish cut cycle. Now since I simulated this in a simulation environment, I changed the tool. Okay, I changed the tool, but while we are writing a manual code, okay, we are not going to change the tool. Okay, we are not going to change the tool. The manual code writing exercise is just to make you understand. Okay, there is a CAN cycle for rough cut simultaneous facing and turning, and there is a finishing CAN cycle for simultaneous facing and turning. So So the rough cut cycle is using G code G73, and finished cycle is using G code G72. And normally, if you are using Cant cycle for roughing and for the facing and turning, simultaneous facing and turning, you have to use finishing cycle as well. Okay, so G73 should be followed by G72. Okay, that is mandatory as far as the manual part programming is concerned. So let us just look at the manual part program. Okay, the usual start of the program with percent sign, then I have the program number. Okay, X0 center line of spindle, Z0 part end. Now I will first prepare the machine G00, G95, G71, G90. So rapid mode, per revolution field rate, metric mode and absolute positioning. Okay, I will reset the home position or return to the home position. So G28, U0 dot, W0 dot. Then I will put my machine in a high gear mode and I will select the turret number 01 and the offset value from register 01. Okay, so M42 T0101, that is the turret I am selecting. Then I will switch on the spindle at 400 rpm clockwise, and I will also switch on the coolant supply. To be more specific, it is flood type coolant supply. So S400, M03, M07. Then I will have my rough turning cycle. Okay, then I will have my rough turning cycle. So that is G73. Okay, how I came to know the line number for P? As I mentioned, when the block in which I write my rough turning cycle, okay, the rough turning cycle should begin immediately after the next block. So that is how I came to know this current line number or sequence number is N050 or 050. Okay, so next line is 060. So that is how P got 060. Okay, now what should be the Q number? Okay, that can be only told once we finish tracing the entire tool path. Okay, so you can leave this for the time being. Okay, now stock to leave on X, that is X axis is 2 mm. Stock to leave on the Z axis is 1 mm. Okay. Now depth of cut is 2 mm and feed is 0.5 millimeter per revolution. Okay, feed is 0.5 millimeter per revolution. Now in this problem, okay, these many details were not mentioned. So in a program, if you are willing to write a program, you should have these details. Okay, what is the stock to be left on the X and Z? Okay, in a rough cut cycle, which can be later carried out with the help of finish cut cycle. Okay, so stock to left on X is 2 mm, stock to leave on Z is 1 mm, the depth of cut is 2 mm. So that will decide based on the total diameter reduction, okay, how many passes can be carried out. Okay, so this is a depth of cut. Okay, now with this number we can find out how many passes will be carried out. Okay, so G00, X30, Z0. So what I am doing, I am setting the tool somewhere over here. Okay, X30. Okay, X30, remember we are working with diameter mode. Okay, X30. So the tool is just about to touch this particular point. Okay, and Z5. So my center is over here. So Z5 means it is not in contact with the workpiece at this point of time. Okay, then we will start the programming. So this is the first line to bring the tool close to the workpiece, and then G01 Z-30. Okay, G01 Z-30. So from this point the turning begins, and the second position from point number 1 to point number 2, that is Z-30, will be achieved. Okay, since it's a straight line path, so G01 I am writing. Then from there X50 Z-40. So X50 Z-40, this is point number 3. Okay, X50, you can see since the diameter that we have is 50, so X dimension is 50 and Z dimension we already reached to minus 30 and then plus 10, so it will become minus 40. So it is X50 Z-40. Okay, then Z-100, so it is again a horizontal line. Okay, Z-100, so this Z-40 we already reached, then Z-100, so from point 3 to point 4 it is a horizontal path, So only turning, straight turning is going to happen till point 4. So Z minus 100. Okay, then X 70. So perpendicular up. So it is going to be point number 5. So from X 50 to X 70, as you can see, the diameter over here is 70. So this will be the direction from 4 to 5. Okay, then X, then in the next line Z minus 120. Okay, Z minus 120. So from point number 5 to point number 6, okay, the total Z length which we have traversed from here, that is till here, it was 100. So plus 20, so it will be total 120. Since we are in the negative direction, so it is going to be Z minus 120. Okay, Z minus 120. And then the final leap, that is X 80. So from this position 6, we will go to position 7, or 0.6 to 0.7, from diameter X equal to 70 to X equal to 80. So that is why X 80. So when I write this X 80, okay, I have turned and faced, simultaneous face turn till point number 7, which was the requirement. Okay, now remember, in manual part programming, we are only going to trace this path once. So we will write the program to trace the mentioned path only once. Okay, now in actual, we will have to do it multiple times. Okay, in actual practice, we will have to do it multiple times, or it will actually happen multiple times, because we have given some depth of cut, and if my diameter, okay, if my diameter is this, so it will have offset tool paths, okay, till this diameter, and as we come near to this diameter, okay, probably the offset tool path will be line, okay, initially single line, then it will slowly try to follow this tool path, okay, till it reaches this point. So that's what we saw on this. I'll just run it again. So as you can see, initially it is single line, then as it comes closer to the actual end workpiece dimensions, okay, the toolpath takes its the actual can say lines, okay, line diagrams. So X 80 we have traversed till point number 7. So and then what we will do, we will take the tool back to the rapid retrieval, back to the starting point. So I will take my tool back to the starting point, saying Z0X30. Okay, Z0X30. So Z0 will take it to the starting point here. Okay, starting point here, and X30. So it will come back to this location. Okay, from here it will directly come back to this location. So the motion will be this. Okay, motion will be this. It will come back to this location. Okay, now we got this particular line number. So till we bring our tool back to the starting point, okay, from where we started, remember 060, we started from X30 Z0, and in 130, line number 130, we brought our tool back to the same starting location. So this is going to be the my Q number. So Q 130 I will write here once I reach to this particular point. Okay, so From there, I will come to know what is the end line number for my rough cut turning cycle. Okay, so the next line is going to be the finish cut turning cycle. So I will write G72, and I will give same line numbers, P060, Q130. Now what will be machined? Only this 2 mm axis in X direction and 1 mm axis in Z direction will be machined using this finish cut CAN cycle for simultaneous turn and face. Okay, simultaneous turning and facing. So only these 2 mm in X and 1 mm in Z will be machined in this finishing cycle. Then I will take my tool back to the home position. So return to home, G28 U0 W0. I will switch off the spindle, I will switch off the coolant, and then the program will end. So I hope this manual part program is understood. Okay, it was very simple, just to trace this path. There were no radiuses, so only G01 was the code. Okay, everywhere linear interpolation was required. Okay, but you can still work with any radius, internal radius, external radius. Okay, so that is it about the CAN cycle for facing and turning. Okay, rough CAN cycle and finished CAN cycle, G73, G72. And this is the manual program which we saw. Okay, now the next thing that we will be going to look is grooving on let. Okay, now as I mentioned, different controllers will have different codes. Okay, we try to use most common codes, okay, but some of the specific operations like grooving, okay, may differ in its G code from controller to controller. So this is, see, normally you will find G77, okay, on FANUC controller, okay, but you will also find G75, okay, on some of the other controllers. So it can either be G75 or G77 for OD or ID, that is outer diameter or internal diameter grooving cycle. Okay, grooving cycle. So the setup is like this. This is a retraction, rarely used. This is a total depth, okay, or the total lengthwise dimension. This is the for single grooving, the K dimension. So the details are mentioned over here. And for grooving, okay, you can if the grooving depth is large, okay, you can work that out with the help of PEC. Okay, so PEC is a shorter depth which will be achieved. Okay, and then slowly the depth will keep on increasing, just like we do in large depth drills. Okay, so we use pecking, okay, so that the tool doesn't get damaged. Okay, so X is a X axis absolute peck depth, okay, diameter value. Z, that is Z axis absolute location to the furthest peck. Okay, so Z will be the total total length of the groove, you can say. Then U is a X axis incremental pecking depth. Okay, so this is the incremental pecking depth that we can specify. Okay, W is Z axis incremental distance and direction. So this is the W as it can be seen over here. K is a Z axis shift increment between pecking cycles. So how many grooves we want to make, okay, will be decided by K. If Z is the total, okay, and let's say K number is here, it is going to be 2. So there are 2 grooves to be made. Okay, 2 grooves to be made. Okay, D is tool shift amount when returning to clearance plane. Okay, and then F is a feed rate. Now all the asterisk marks, okay, can be optional. Okay, may not be provided all the time. Okay, depends on the special cases. So G75, G77. Okay, canned cycle can be used for grooving an outside diameter with chip break. Okay, with this canned cycle, either a single pecking cycle can be executed as for a single groove, or a series of pecking cycles can be performed for multiple grooves. Okay, when a Z or W code is added to G75, G77 block and Z is not the current position, then a minimum of 2 pecking cycles will occur. Okay, one at the current location and another at the Z location. So as we will take an example on this, we will take example for single groove and for multipass groove. The K code is the incremental distance between Z axis pecking cycles. Adding a K will perform multiple evenly spaced pecking cycles between the starting position S and Z. Okay, so when I specify K, okay, I will be having those many number of grooves as I mentioned earlier. If the distance between S and Z is not evenly divisible by K, then the last interval along Z will be less than K. So whatever the whole number available will be the number of grooves, and the remaining will be the last interval, okay, which will be less than K. Okay, which will be less than K. So that is how the number of grooves and taking parameters are decided. Okay, so let us look at the G75 single pass OD grooving cycle. So what is requirement? The single groove is required, and that groove dimension is same as the cutter dimension. Okay, cutter dimension. So what will happen? The tool will come here, tool will make a groove, tool will come up and go back to the original position. Okay, that is the requirement. So this is a simple program. Okay, we'll just see the simulation environment, how this is going to happen. So if I just execute this. So as you can see, the depth that is required is of the depth of the tool. So this is the depth of the tool, and this is the groove that is required to be taken. Okay, so for this we are going to write a very simple manual part program. Okay, so again percent sign O9005 is a program number, single grooving can cycle program. Okay, G28U0W0 return to home position. Okay, G00, G95, G71, G90. So rapid mode per revolution feed rate, metric mode of operating and absolute positioning system. Now I am going to set a medium gear for this M41 and the turret number 1 and offset value will be taken from register 1. The spindle speed I will be keeping as 1000 RPM clockwise, so S1000 M03 and flood type coolant will be on. Okay, then G00, X112 and Z5. Okay, now the dimensions for this is a diameter 100. Okay, diameter is 100. Okay, this length is, let's say, 5. Okay, 5 mm. Okay, which is well equivalent with the tool's width. Okay, and this distance is, let's say, 10 mm. Okay, this distance is 10 mm. So based on that, these dimensions are coming. So X112, it is well above. Okay, well above the workpiece, and Z5, it is not touching the workpiece. So this is position 1. Then we'll bring it back to Z-25. Okay, now -25 is this point. Okay, -25 is this point. So Z-25, this distance is 20, this distance is 5. So this is Z-25, happens to be this point. Okay, so it comes to Z-25. Then we write the single groove cycle. So G75, X80. Okay, X80. So we write the depth as far as the groove depth is concerned. So X80, we write the absolute diameter value. So this particular distance is 10 in terms of the section. Okay, and the total diameter reduction from both side happens, that is 80. So 20 mm gets reduced. So the absolute dimension of the diameter when the at this particular point is 80. Okay, so that is why X80. Okay, then I 0.05. Okay, so that is the incremental depth required in terms of the passes. Okay, now here it is going to be a single pass and entirely the 20 mm diameter will be reduced, and from 100 it will reduce to 80, and the feed rate that we will be carrying out is 0.127 millimeters per revolution. Okay, millimeters per revolution. So this is exactly what we saw over here. Just I will run it again. Okay, tool comes to X80. Okay, goes up and again goes back to the home position. Okay, again goes back to the home position. So this is a pretty simple grooving cycle program, single groove cycle program. Okay, so then we switch off the spindle, switch off the coolant, then again G28 to take tool back to the home position, and then M30 program ends. Okay, M30 program ends. I hope you have understood. The trickiest part over here is just to mention G75 additionally. Apart from that, it doesn't require much data, as you would see over here. Okay, all these values are optional. So if we don't give these values, still the program is going to work. Okay, still the program is going to work. Okay, we can get rid of this I value as well, because in a single pass or single grooving cycle, okay, I may not be that much effective. Okay, and being I value very small, okay, any which way I will not be coming into picture in this single groove cycle. The tool is directly coming down, as we saw in this simulation environment. See, tool directly comes down, yeah, there. Okay, and it goes out. So that's it. Okay, the I doesn't really come into picture. If you write, okay, like this, okay, still the program is not going to consider it, because this value is very small compared to the total diameter reduction that we are doing in a single groove cycle. Okay, so I hope this is understood. Next up, we have the multipass OD grooving. So the dimensions are same, only thing is the groove dimension. From earlier it was 5 mm, now it is 15 mm. Okay, 5 mm, now it is 15 mm. So this particular point was -25, Z-25, and this point is now Z-40. Okay, Z-40. So these are the only changes. Let us just look how it is happening. So now it is a multi-pass grooving cycle. As you can see, it enters at Z minus 25 and then it goes in the left direction till Z minus 40. Okay, and it finishes the grooving. Okay, it finishes the grooving. As you can see, entered at minus 25 and then went ahead. Okay, so these lines, as you can see, okay, these lines are the additional length of the groove which is getting machined. Okay, in a multi-pass cycle. Okay, in a multi-pass cycle for grooving. Okay, and apart from that, all other dimensions are same. Okay, so we'll just quickly look at the manual part program for multi-pass grooving. So O9006 multi-pass grooving cycle program, G28 resetting to the home position. Okay, then I'm setting the machine with manual with rapid mode, per revolution feed rate, metric mode and absolute positioning system. Then M41 T0101, so medium gear, turret number 1, offset value taken from register 1. Speed is going to be again 1000 RPM. The spindle is going to rotate clockwise and flood type coolant will be on. Okay, G00 rapid positioning this particular positioning. Okay, G00 X112Z5. Okay, and then from there I will bring the tool to Z minus 25. Okay, and then I will write the multi-pass grooving cycle. So G75 X80 Z minus 40. So here I have to write absolute values. So X80 is absolute value. Z minus 40 is also an absolute value. Okay, I 0.05 K3. Okay, I 0.05 K3. So depth is the step over distance is mentioned. So K is, as you can see, Z axis shift increment between peaking cycles. So the total total Z that it has to fetch is somewhere around minus 15, okay, minus 15, and the single pass dimension in terms of Z, that is K dimension I have taken, is 3. So you can say 3 number of passes will be required, or for that matter 4 number of passes will be required. The last pass will have smaller distance, okay, smaller distance as we saw over here. Okay, so if the K code is the incremental distance between Z axis peaking cycles, adding K will perform multiple evenly spaced peaking cycles. So now what is happening? 3 cycles will be performed with the help of K value equal to 3, and the distance between Z is not evenly divisible by K, then the last interval along Z will be less than K. So last interval will be of value 1. Okay, last interval will be of value 1, and that is how it will total cover the remaining 10 additional 10 distance. Okay, as we see over here. So one more time I will just run this. So this is the first pass, second, third, fourth, fifth, and then we have some finish passes. Okay, so as you can see, this 1, this 2, and this 3. So these 3 blue lines are the rough passes, and then you have 1 or 2 finishing passes just to machine that remaining 1 mm distance, okay, in terms of the Z dimension till it reaches Z minus 40. Okay, so that will happen over here at feed rate 0.127 millimeter per revolution. Okay, and entire groove will be made, okay, in this block itself. Then I will switch off the spindle, switch off the coolant. I will take my tool back to the home position, so return to home using G28. Then I will end the program, and with the percent sign the program ends. So I hope you have understood the 3 things which we studied in this particular lecture, that is the G73, G72, that is rough cut, simultaneous facing and turning, and finish cut, simultaneous facing and turning, G73, G72 respectively. Then we studied about G75, that is the grooving cycle on the lathe machine, okay, the single grooving cycle and multi-pass grooving cycle, and we also saw the programs, manual part programming for a simple groove, okay, single groove, and then using a multi-pass groove, okay, multi-pass groove. So I hope this is understood. Just stay tuned for more such interesting content on the CAD-CAM CAE lecture series as well as computer aided manufacturing. Okay, till then, thank you very much.